Hey. Hello from my garage.
Thanks for showing up.
Oh, well, we're here in my garage because I got kicked out of the house. So they're all in there, all the women, you know. I don't know what they're doing. Not allowing me to be in there. So I'm out here. This is my little workbench here. And thanks to American Songwriter for having us on.
There's a...
She says there's a... Can you do that again? Like a high-pitched noise?
Yeah.
Are you watching the video?
Yeah.
Oh. I don't know what it is. Anyway, if there's a high-pitched noise, sorry. I can try to move. Anyway, thanks to American Songwriter for having me on here. I'm Logan Mize. I'm here in lovely Kansas today. And we live out here in kind of the middle of nowhere. It's great. And Big Yellow Dog is a company I've been with for 10 years. Actually, I think I'm on my 11th year. So, Carla and Carrie and everybody there. I hope you enjoyed the earlier live shows with Keelan and Tennille and Jeremy. Great songwriters, great people. And I got some questions here. If you tuned in for theirs, you know the drill. I got like some questions here that I'm gonna answer. So, and I got kind of a set list. I'm not good at sticking to it, but I'm gonna try. So, okay. The most influential person in my career. Probably the girl who just came out here, my wife, and said there's a high-pitched noise. Oh, she just turned it off. See, she's a genius. And, I was living in a van when I met her. True story. I was living in a Suburban, and was it the...
the alarm's going off.
The alarm? Yeah, okay. It was our septic alarm, so that's not good. Anyway, I was living in a Suburban, and she kind of convinced me to get my life together. And then now we've been married 10 years and have two kids. And so anyway, here, I'm going to... Start with this song. Gotta thank a small town preacher making me a hymn singer. Sunday's mama made me go. Gotta thank a high school teacher, even in a dreamer. Couldn't ask for a better best friend. Gotta thank Earnhardt Springsteen, Luke Skywalker for filling out my family plan. Gotta thank J.D. Jimmy, Mr. N. Hazard for a Friday night good time. Mama and the daddy for 18 years, then gassing up the Chevrolet time. Matter of fact, everybody's got somebody. I'll never forget. There you go. Thank you very much. So it looks like we got some people on there, and thanks for joining. So I'm going to move on to some questions here. And man, I'm sweating here. I was going to be on the porch because it was kind of nice out, and it was a little too windy, which is why I moved it in here. And now I'm kind of sweaty, so it's almost like a real performance. Anyway, so Cool Girl is a song I wrote with Daniel Tashian, who I think is just a genius, great guy, great musician, right? Also a big Yellow Dog dude. And one day he had this title, Cool Girl, and he had the music kind of going, he was strumming around, and I just kind of sat there and started typing Cool Girl, you know, like kind of from the perspective of a girl who maybe thinks she's too good for you, which I've experienced a lot of those, you know, because when you live in a suburban, not a lot of girls think you're attractive or want to date you. So I could write from firsthand experience. Anyway, that's what this song is. It's called Cool Girl. I can see all you guys. Best country artist by far. Man, you need to get out more, man. But thank you very much. Anyway, if you're just joining, welcome to my garage.
This is fun, nice and laid back. I gave up alcohol for Lent, and it went really well, but Lent's over, so I had a little nice little Highland single malt here, so cheers. I'm gonna go ahead and I got questions to answer. Hope you can hear me all right. Let's see here. The role of a publisher in a songwriter's career, I would say, it's a big one, especially in my case, because my publishing company is essentially also my record label. I've been with them for 10 plus years. So when I first started, I was pretty young. I was 24, 25, and just getting started. I had one other publishing deal before, but I didn't really know, what publishing meant, I had no idea really. I just knew that this guy was going to pay me to write songs, and it lasted a year, and I kind of figured it out. So when I got to Big Yellow Dog, I kind of realized the publishing company is a lot more than what I initially had thought. There's so many things that go into it, and Carla is great at, she's a great song person, so she can hear something and immediately know, like, oh, this would be good for such and so. And she's helped guide me too as well, like, hey, this song, maybe, yeah, this is great, or this not so much. And sometimes we agree, sometimes we don't, but either way, she's a great publisher and she has a track record to prove it. So I don't know if she's on here, but hey, Carla, if you are, I'm just trying to butter you up a little. Love you. And anyway, no, Big Yellow Dog's a great publisher, and Carla found me this song. There was a point in my career where I thought I was going to write all my own songs. I thought I had to. Maybe that was my ego, or maybe it was just I thought that's what you had to do. And then I realized that there's a lot better songwriters out there, or there's a lot better songs than I had, maybe, and so I started cutting some outside songs too. And I've been able to make friends with Donovan Woods, a great songwriter, Canadian dude. And he wrote this song with Age DeClosa. And it kind of changed our lives. So it was really big last year. Anyway, I'll shut up and sing. That's what they say, right?
Station turned to static. She ain't never been that far from home. I know she.
Man, it's been a long time since I played live. It's been like 2 months, over 2 months. Yes, Josh Cherry, what's up, man? So I'm gonna get to a couple of these questions. So I'm gonna do you a song that hasn't come out yet. It comes out, I think, Father's Day weekend-ish. The question is, what inspired this song? So I was actually on tour out on the West Coast with my friend Will Hogue, and I was playing acoustic out there, and a friend of mine, Blake Chaffin, great songwriter, and he's also from Kansas, but we were in Flagstaff, Arizona, and my wife was pregnant with our second child at the time. She's now five, our daughter is Violet, but I was nervous. I was gonna have a baby girl, you know, and you think about how they're gonna be treated and how people will, you know, there's just a lot going through your mind. And so my friend Blake had this title called Prettiest Girl in the World. I think he did. I don't think I did. I don't know. We'll give him credit because I think he probably did. And so we tried to write it, and I kind of wrote it from the perspective of, it could, you know, it's a little bit, it could be a relationship with your significant other, or talking to a girl, but I kind of had my unborn daughter in mind when I wrote it. And I haven't really played this since, I think I played it once or twice on tour on the West Coast back in February, so we'll see if I can pull it off. What do you guys, if you guys want to hear anything too, a Glenn tour again, yeah, we can do that. Hope you're having fun. Thanks again for watching. All right. Let's see if I can make it through this.
Pretty
go. Thank you very much. Seems like we're still holding everybody in here, which is pretty cool.
I think she likes it. Hey, Dan, what's up, dude? Well, maybe she's lucky. I don't know. Is she? Oh, welcome to Prairieville, huh? Okay, I can do that for you.
I don't know if I'm gonna get in trouble for it or not. It wasn't on the set list, but, what the heck? We're all here. You're requesting songs, so I'll do it for you. So the only way you would know this is if you've been to a live show, and we don't play it that often, so I think there's one on YouTube, a version of it, but... this is a... it's kind of a fictitious town that I just write about when I run out of ideas to write about, and, you know, it's hard to go down to Music Row and just write a song every day at 10 or 11, whatever time it used to be 10 when I first moved to town, then it like drifted to 11, 11:30, but yeah, you get down there and it's like, okay, today, what are we going to write a song about? And I don't necessarily write like that. So I just kind of let things pile up over here in my peripheral for days, weeks, months, sometimes years. And if something kind of pokes out at me, I'll pursue it, but I don't like to just sit down every day and just charge at it. But I was doing that a lot and for a while, and so what I did is I made up this town called Prairieville, and kind of based on where we're at right now. You can't see, but there's nothing out here. We're in the middle of the prairie. And so I just kind of based it on people I grew up around out here, and every time I was stuck and didn't have an idea, it's like, well, I'll write a song about somebody in Prairieville or something that happened there. And I just have this collection of songs that have kind of grown over the years. And I really want to make an album to put out of all of them. But this is Welcome to Prairieville. Jacob, thanks for requesting it, brother. I'm glad you dig it.
Gotta bring your crew.
always pulls me back. Just can't seem to let it go. Maybe it's the water. Just gets in your blood. Some of the dust gets in your soul. Don't understand it. I tried leaving, but it always pulls me back. I just can't seem to let it go. Maybe it's the water that just gets in your blood. Some of the dust gets in your soul. Don't understand it, and I never will. Welcome to Prairieville. That shiny right on the edge of town. Population keeps going down, and there's for sale signs on just about everything. There you go. Thank you very much.
Thanks again, Jacob, for requesting that. Yeah, no kidding, right? I think it was a tractor or a sprayer or something. Good God, that thing was loud. I don't know if you could hear it. Anyway, so I don't know how much time I have left, how long I've been on here, but I see some Follow Your Heart. That's not out either. When I Grow Out's not released. How do you know these songs? Follow Your Heart. How do you know? I tried to put that on the record like multiple times and no avail. Claus, what's up, man? Thanks for the guitar, man. That thing looks amazing.
Holy smokes.
So Claus Spindler's from Germany, he just made me a Telemaster, and it looks awesome. I just saw a picture of it today.
Love it, dude.
You know what? I'll do
Hometown, which is our current single.
Claus, I think, requested it, and I got a tune to a different tuning. And while I'm doing that, I'll answer some questions. So,
let's see.
How have you grown while at Big Yellow Dog? I kind of already answered that, but I've been there a long time and went from not really having any fans and I was touring kind of, you know, when I first got in there, but they've really helped kind of develop and grown, helped me grow into being able to go out and tour across the world. So it's been really cool to do that outside, especially outside of the mainstream. You know, country radio and all that. So it's been really cool. Let's see what else here. What stood out about this song, the next one I'm going to play, to make it a single? I heard this song. I didn't write it. Steven Wilson and Tony Lane did, and Marv Green. Tony Lane has, gosh, been my favorite songwriter since I moved to Nashville. And I've always just, there's a lot of times I've tried to emulate him, you know, writing, or everybody tries to. He's incredible. And so when I heard this song, it really felt like something that I just had to have. It was one of those like moments for the 100th time where I fell in love with the Tony Lane song. And Steven Wilson is just this magical dude. Marv Green is just amazing too. So it's a really, the three of those guys writing a song. I mean, I'll cut those songs all day long. But I heard it, it just felt like something I would do. And I hope you guys are digging it, because it just came out and it's doing really well, so I'm excited about it. What else? Yeah, I kind of answered most of that. So once I get tuned up here, I'm going to give it a shot. I've never played this acoustic before. Actually, I've never played this out at all. It just came out. So I'll do my best. This is a weird tuning I kind of just created here. I'm sure somebody's used it before. Mm-hmm.
like a steel guitar in a disco song. I've been going nowhere since I've been gone. I end up here where I don't belong. I wanna be home, my own hometown. Back where my roots ran wild in my barefoot stomping ground. Yeah, I wanna wake up to some of that cooking. Know my way around without looking home. My own hometown. I'm always gonna be home. Yeah. I'm always gonna be home. Town, yeah. Black dirt boots just don't fit in. Thick and they smile too thin. Ain't no wildflowers blowing here in the wind. These black dirt boots just don't fit in. I wanna be home, on hometown. Back where my roots ran wild in my barefoot stomping ground. Yeah, I wanna wake up to some of that. Know my way around without looking home. My own hometown. I'm always gonna be hometown, yeah. I'm always gonna be hometown, yeah. Now there's a graveyard there where my granddad is. And the speed of life that I sure do. That high school crush that I never did kiss. I wanna be home, on hometown. Wanna be home, on hometown. Yeah, back where my roots ran wild in my barefoot stomping ground. Yeah, I wanna wake up to some of that cooking. No,
new single. It's called Hometown. Oh, Heather, I'm so sorry. I just played Cool Girl. It was like the second one. But thanks for tuning in. I don't know if this is the end or not, but hey, sweetie girl. El Camino. Oh, my kids are holding up signs that say El Camino. I'm guessing that means somebody requested it. My Gibson Country and Western is in the shop. I had to get an entire rebuild. So I'm playing the Voyager, which this is a great guitar too. It's a 64. Love this thing. It's not quite the 69 Country and Western, but it sounds amazing, and I really love it. It's been in the shop for 3 months, so I'm hoping to get it back. And so I'm guessing since they showed me that, somebody requested El Camino. I'll do it. American Songwriter, thanks again for having me. I appreciate it. I hope you're not trying to kick me off of here. If you are, just get on there and shut me off. But I wrote this song with my friend Blake, who I wrote for the Prairieville song with. And this is a stupid song, and it's we both know that, and we knew it when we wrote it. But that's usually the first indication that a song is going to be kind of dumb when you tune down into drop D. I just made that up. I don't know if that's true. It seems like something douchey to do. This song is, It's really dumb. It's just about this guy trying to hit on... It's about the guy in your hometown who still drives an El Camino and goes to the high school parties and buys them all beer. He's like 40, and every town has one. And then we had one in our hometown. He drove an El Camino. He bought us all beer. Just, okay, here you go. Thanks for requesting it. Let's have a party in my El Camino. You bring the word to the baby, I bring the bees. We can blow this town and go get parked on the back road. We'll get you rocking if you know what I mean. I got a mixtape with the best of Cerro. Let's have a party in my El Camino. So your daddy tells you very much. And that was El Camino. I appreciate you guys tuning in. I really have no idea how much time I'm supposed to do this. If I'm supposed to stop at some point, I know it's been 45 minutes, 41 minutes. But hello from Georgia. Hi, Susan. Hope you're doing well. The good life. Okay, I'll do that for you. If you guys keep requesting songs, I'll keep playing. So as long as I don't make the American songwriting folks mad. I'll keep playing requests. Thanks for requesting this, man. This is on my second album, and it was my first album I put out with Big Yellow Dog in 2012. Daniel Tashin produced it, and I wrote this song with Blake Chaffin, same guy. I pretty much wrote every song I've played with, well, half of them that I've played. And, yeah, man, this is my favorite one on that record, and I think it was our first radio single, and it was just like to tertiary, like small radio markets, but there was little pockets around the country that played it quite a bit, and so when we first started touring on this album, it was really cool to see like the places that knew it. So I can't remember who requested that, but thank you. I'll do it just for you, buddy. Back road, yeah, man. All right, I keep saying I'm gonna stop, and then you guys keep throwing out songs. So I don't know. Oh, Boys from Back Home, Come Back Road. Hey,
June Scott from Quebec. Hope you're doing well up there. Is it warm up there yet? Oh, cool. They said American Songwriter says please keep playing. Oh, Ain't Always Pretty. I forgot about that one. Okay. Used Up with a little background. Sunflowers.
Man, you guys know them all. Okay. If you're not leaving, I guess I'm not either. Cheers. I didn't know people actually had this long of an attention span. But, all right, so what'd you say? You said... Boys from Back Home, Sunflowers, Used Up. Oh, Ain't Always Pretty, that's what it was. I always forget about that one. This is actually one that was on the set list, and I always forget about this damn song. For some reason, which is weird because it was like my first big streaming song. It streamed like 39 million times on Spotify. And, okay. This is what I mean when I say loud tractors are driving by. You can see out there, there's a sprayer going. So, anyway, all right. Not making this up. Yeah, so Bobby Bones played this song. It was the first single off my last album, Comeback Road. And I sent it to him, and I'd met Bobby maybe one time. And he played it one morning on his show, and I mean, I was fully expecting like the typical independent release, which isn't, you know, not a bad thing, but you're catering to your, you know, your core fan base most of the time. And so, and you can do pretty well and make a good living, but like when that song got sent to Bobby, he played it on his morning show, you know, and he has a huge, huge following. So I think it was like shot straight to the top of the download charts back when, I guess, people downloaded songs more, but it was crazy. It was right behind, it was like half, less than a percentage point behind that CMA song that had the 50 artists sing on it for the CMA 50 year thing. And it was really wild. So, and it was like trending number 9 in the world, and I was not used to that sort of thing. I'm used to being in the indie, independent kind of thing. So it was our first foray into that world. And I got, you know, every time I see him, I still say thank you, man. It was really cool for him to do that. So it launched that album, Come Back Around, in a big way. So here you go. This is Ain't Always Pretty.
As your fast food bag wadded up in your backseat, old fence pole staring right back at you. Here you feel at the 7-Eleven, still hot in hell in the shade of 7. Cash my check, fill up the tank, buy you a flower and buy us a drink to sip on, to live on. Watching that sun drip on the field of green. Maybe I wouldn't change a thing. It ain't always pretty, but you are easy, but it ain't too hard. Meet me at the corner pub, say you see. Won't be anybody there looking at me. Oh, blue kind of blue eyed worth it. Yeah, whatever we do is worth it. Mac, Jack, and Dad, and just singing our daily life goes on. It ain't always pretty, but you are. Smacking on the fridge, you there holding me and you laughing at the kind of fair. Merry-go-round and that we go, just like these dusty nowhere roads. It's too dry, raining, it's either hurry up or waiting. I love that you like the way I sing. Sunday morning cigarette, amazing grace, it ain't always pretty, but you are. Easy, good, but it ain't too hard.
Thanks for requesting that. I would have completely forgot about it. Man, you guys are throwing out all sorts of stuff.
Good Life. I just played Good Life. All right, you know what? We're going to do, this is it. I'm going to do, because we're getting so many requests, and I would love to be here all night. I'll do one more song. How about that? And Sunflowers. I saw somebody send me a message today. Please play Sunflowers. So I'm going to do it for you. I also wrote this song with Blake, my friend. Blake Chaffin, great songwriter, Kansas dude. And this was also on my second album. So I'm going to do this, and then I'm out of here. You guys have a wonderful Monday evening, wherever you're at. And yeah, this is Sunflowers. We wrote this with Mark D. Sanders, who was a legend. It was a fun day. So thanks again, guys. I appreciate it. Be good out there. Black smoke rolling out of the tailpipe, down a dirt road, old rusty wheels still spinning like new. Bob wire fence poles and blue skies forever. White frame farmhouse with a front porch view. Hey, I'd give anything for a front porch view. And they say some souls were just born to run, and I grew up thinking I was one. But I'm drawn to the west where I'm from, like a sunflower. Searching for water, the years move slow when you're waiting on rain. Life ain't nothing like a postcard picture. It's a tumbleweed blowing across a dusty plain. Be a tumbleweed blowing across a Kansas. I'm Logan Mize, and you guys are awesome. Thanks for hanging in there with me. Hopefully this is over soon, and we can have like a real show. So anyway, see ya. Be good.